control of your heart. You never go wrong.
Got it. Thank you, Mr. Dibbs. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome y'all to the Chippy Bun Club this evening. I'm your host for the night, Big Bad Brother Ali. On the wheels of steel, controlling the maestro, we got none other than Mr. Motherfucking Dibbs. Come on, dog. We just want y'all to ride. Vibe with us, lady. Served 18 months out of World War II. European theater for the red, white, and blue. He watched from the deck with what remained of his crew as his home finally came into view. And the segregated army had made him a sergeant. He came back hard and looking like a wood carving. Bobby Green in all his magnificence embraced his young bride. She felt so innocent. He tried to sleep, but he had chest murmurs. And wake up at night trying to bayonet Germans. She would ask him, but all he'd tell is that they ain't never lied when they said war was hell. She didn't need to hear about the fires and bombs and how his young friends used to die in his arms. Maybe wouldn't even know where to start. He kept a photograph in the pocket over his heart. Oh, he could kill strangers with the best of them. Every last color soldier got nothing but respect for him. He came home, it's like he ain't even grown. Rent rooms, he ain't even got a place of his own. Missed his daddy's funeral, fighting for freedom. Returned to find out that his wife didn't need him. Cause while the man of the house was vacant, she learned to earn enough to break bread and pay rent. The army awarded him the Medal of Honor. He now flees twice with a cramp in his posture. Yes sir, no ma'am, kill for these people with his own hands. Can't get respected as a grown man. Now that's what you call working poor. Can't afford to bring his woman home, nothing from the store. But on the first Saturday of every month, she could wear the blue dress and eat whatever she wants. And she's queen for a day. And needless to say, that's the only reason he has to breathe in a way. And on that night, they were waiting for a dish. He excused himself from the table to piss. And in his absence, a young bad motherfucker stepped up like he think he James Cagney or something. No, baby, she said, that's mighty kind of you, but I am a married woman and I'm here with my husband. He grabbed her arm and tried to hold firm. She pulled away and she said, I already told you, sir. He drew back, slapped her face, got his bar stool back and tossed another group back. Bobby returned to find tears in her eyes and she's so shook up that she can't tell him why. Gathered her composure, told the story. Bobby kept his wits about him and approached him calmly. Then something happened inside and snapped. And he struck him so hard that his eyes rolled back and his body collapsed. Grabbed him by the armpits, lifted and drug him outside in the back. And right there in the still of the night, Bobby beat the young man within an inch of his life. It might have been what he did to his wife. I imagine that straw with the arm it would take to break a camel's back. They all flocked from inside to get a scene. Jaws dropped, they were too horrified to intervene. He had a face down, naked from the waist down. And what happened next cleared the whole playground. See, Bobby had already did what his hands could. Spent the next 10 minutes stripping his manhood, brutalizing him. He not gay, but he had to go inside of him to really take his pride from him. Kid disappeared to who knows where. And Bobby and his wife Ethel still live here. And they never spoke about it for the rest of their life. That's all they called it was that night. That night when the pillar crumbled. That night when the stone wall cracked and it all collapsed. That night a desperate person at the end of his chain got tired of trying to make sense of the pain. That night when the statue stumbled. That night when the stone wall cracked and it all collapsed. That night a desperate person at the end of his chain got tired of trying to make sense of the pain. That night